So welcome back, Nana here, and then we are in the next day's program of this Fusion Order Management Implementation, and then we are going ahead on this. We are into the advanced shipping actually. So I'll go there. This time I will now work on my company instance. I have not shown you about how to work on a Vision instance actually. So I will now let us know. I will now go to the Fusion Order Management documentation, and then I will now open up the advanced shipping. Somebody asked me where exactly the document is. So in your order management documentation, the advanced shipping document is here. Advanced shipping, you can just open it up now. So the first one we already completed now. So I will now go ahead and then create the next one now. Fine. Next one I'm going to build. So let me go there and then log in into this now. Minimize it. Just keep a watch on the record icon. If it goes away, what happens, immediately inform me now so that I had a command and leave. So we'll cancel it now. Come out of this now.
Cloud
planning and this one, IT crew can it do the scheduling in this one, cloud, or is it mandatory? Okay, fine. We'll now go there and then we'll now do it in the space. And then let me log in.
Anand?
Yeah, tell me, yeah.
Without ATP rule and without planning, can I do scheduling and reservation in cloud?
Yeah, yeah. We are now doing like that. Without ATP and without JOB, and then without ATP, we are doing it. As of now, it is an infinite ATP on which you are doing now. So the present thing are now done on an infinite ATP. If you don't have a GOP license, ATP and GOP are not required. Only when you have a GOP, then only what happens, you need those things.
Even if without giving any ATP rule.
See, that all becomes a license now. If you don't have a GOP license, this is the present one. Fine. Whatever you're doing is without GOP and then without ATP. Got it? Good. So now I now go there and then create my item now. Second item I'm going to create now.
Hi Nana, good morning.
Yeah, good morning. Yeah. So in this case, what happens? Serial number, serial generation and inventory. So in this case, items are mass produced in FGS and then actual warranty starts upon powering or usage start. So this is what is. So we are now going to define an item with a serial, fine, with an entry at inventory pick. Fine. At inventory pick, we are going to do it. So I'll now go to the product management and then I go to the product information management. I'm now working on my instance actually because people fiddle around on the Vision instances and so what happens? My thing should not stop actually. So that I come back to my instance now. So organization is D01 and then 0. Fine. Only the master org will be coming. The child orgs will not come now. I will not put the root item class over here now. So the template is now getting defaulted. I will not give OK now. Accept the template and then go there. So I will now say it's the second item on the advanced shipping. And so I'm now going to give a number also accordingly. I'll be giving D0102. So it's a D0102. And then it is what's called what happens, entry at inventory pick. I'll now go to the specifications and then I have already now click on it. In the specifications, I go to the inventory. So in the inventory, I'm going to make it as what, at pick now. Serial generation at pick now. I will now say it's at pick. Fine. Entry at inventory pick now. Fine. So I will now name the item also accordingly. Fine. While picking only, we have to give the serial number. While receiving it from manufacturing, we'll not be doing it. Serial at pick. So we are now giving the item as a serial at pick. So serial numbers will not be asked when you make a miscellaneous receipt or when you make a manufacturing transaction. When you are manufacturing it, at the time, whatever, it will not be asking any serial numbers at all. Only at the time of pick, it will be asked. So we are now given it. So in an entry at inventory pick. So go there. And then I will now associate with the child org. So 0102 is now getting ready. Actions and then go to select and add. So I am now adding it. So I'll know D011 and then enter now. I'm putting it over here. Click on apply and done. So this second item is now ready. Go there, save and close. We'll now go to the third item. So first of all, look at all the items and go to find whether you want. Third item. So the third item is what? It is a sales order issue actually. So I will now make the third item over here now. Click on it and then click on create item. You're now getting the third item. So it's a D010 and then root item class. Click on OK now. I will now say D0103, fine. Serial at SO issue. So is that the SO issue? Fine. So 03 item is the SO issue. Fine. Paste it now. And then go to the specs and then you go to the inventory and then make a change on the serial control now. So go to the inventory. You are now going to make a change on the serial control now. So serial control is what? At issue now. Fine. This is one. This is one. So we are now seeing the no control. we are not seeing the predefined. I have not gone it. You are not seeing the because they will be explained in the inventory cleaning actually. So we are now mainly concentrating on the inventory pick and then at the sales order ratio. These two things only we are concentrating. The no control also is not done. So at the name of sales order issue, we have to assign the serial numbers actually. So go to the associations and then let me associate it now. Go to actions and then go to select NAT and then I'm going to add it now. So it's a D011 entry now. Select it and then apply and then click on. So go there. The third item is now ready. And give us even close. So we'll now go for the fourth item now. The fourth item is what? Inspection before dispatch. So here we'll now go to facilitate the manual becomes. So this is a locate. And go that you want it. So define and assign an item with a dynamic entry at inventory reserve. And there's all this. And you're going to have a dynamic entry. Now go there and wait number. So click on it. So please mute your mics now. I have no mute all. And then whenever you want to speak, you speak and then you download. And then unmute it. Unmute, speak and then mute. D01. The fourth item I'm now going to create now. Fine. It is going to be a dynamic entry. Root class. So click on it. Okay. The fourth item, you're going to do it now. Fine. Click on it. I'll now go to the specifications now. Specifications, inventory. I'm now going to make it as a dynamic now. Fine. Click on inventory. So here, you're now going to have what? With the dynamic entry at inventory. Go there and then I make a change on the serial control now. I make it as a dynamic entry. So we are almost testing three of the features of a serial control now. So go there and then click on associations and then click on associate with child R. So associate. So it's not coming because item number is not put. Otherwise, that is why the select NAT is not coming. I'll now say D0104, isn't it? Am I correct? 2, 3, and then this is the fourth item. I'll now say serial and then I'll now say dynamic. So 04 is the one. I'm taking it off and go back on it. So second is the pick, and then third is the sales order issue, and then the fourth is the dynamic now. Now if you go to the actions, and then select NAT will be coming because I have to tab it out now. And click somewhere else, and then action select NAT will be. As long as you're in this field, it is not coming. So once when you click somewhere outside, action select NAT is coming. I know that click on it. And then small things, you make an R&D, you'll understand it now. I may not have told each and everything now. So click on that now. So the fourth item is now getting ready. Fine, go ahead, click on it. And then click on save and close. So this is also done. Fine, go ahead, click on it. Now you'll go for the fifth item now. So fifth item is the two variants for shipping for which what happens is we need to customize the workflow actually. Workflow customization is required now. So go there. Is no control item now. Fine, go ahead. I will now say two variants actually. Two variants for is a no control item. Fine, go ahead, click on it. I'll now make it now. Fine, go ahead, click on it. No go and then create it. So is the two variants is the fifth item. D01 and then I'm not going to go for the zero item. I'll put the root item class over here now. So click on it. Click on OK. Fine. No that. And then here you go there. And then it is a no control item. Fine. D0105. Fine. It is what's called. I will now call it as a two variants, which you're going to know. Fine. Two variants. So two variants. Array A M T S. Okay. With two variants. There are two variants in the same fine, for which workflow customization is required. Now, fine, go that click on it. I will not give association. Specifications, I'm not doing anything at all. I go to the association straight away. There's no control. So go to the space, go to the actions, and then go to select NAT. Let me assign to the child. The fifth item. So 2, 3, 4, 5 are now getting ready now. 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we'll now have one more item also for testing. I think probably we'll not be able to do
it. Okay. Item is which control? Item.
Yeah, I'm unable to understand. What is the question?
This item,
is a no control item. Is a no control item. The fifth item is a no control item. Save and control. We will now create one more item for what happens. I'm now going to change the warehouse actually. I'll click on create item. This I'm going to change the warehouse and then see. You know, D01. Then put it on. Fine. I'm going to change the warehouse on the way. The root item class. Click on it. And click on OK now. Is also not having any controls. Nothing other. So D0106. Fine. Change warehouse. So I'm going to change the warehouse and test it now. Actually, I'm going to show you about how to test. Warehouse change. I'm going to make it. This is also one of the important business scenarios in the field. Nothing other. Here I'm going to associate to what? Two different warehouses. Go to the association. So let me associate to both the orgs. Nothing other. Let me associate. And then I'm going to change the warehouse. And then I'm going to show it to you. I will now associate with the control. I'm selecting the child one as well as child two. and then click on apply and then click on done off. So with the control, I'm selecting multiples and then you can see this item is assigned to both. Fine. The remaining are assigned to only first child or seven close. So sixth item is now ready. Now we'll now go there and then pop it to the stop. So for the first of all, you'll go there, you'll now go to the space and then along go to the home icon. And then I go to the supply chain execution and then go to the inventory management. So go there, click on it, and then I will now go to what? I will now go to the manage inventory quantities and then change the org to second org now. Fine. So this last item, sixth item, is now going to have a stock in both orgs. Click on change org and then I will now do it now. Fine. Click on it. The D01. Control item is having a control. Organization is not so. I click on again now. So D012, I have chosen now. I'm going to click on create miscellaneous rule. Here I'm going to have only one transaction on this now. I'm going to click on it. Now make it now. It is 102. Fine. I click on miscellaneous receipt and then I will now choose my account numbers. Now, some account numbers is okay. Fine. Click on search and then wait. In fact, financials will be telling you on which account you have to make a miscellaneous receipt now. And they will be giving you. So drop it down. And then to know more about it, you go to the my structure creation document. There are 12 videos are there. So that will be explaining you in a little bit lecture. So the sixth item now, find D0106 and then you attack. So I'm going to keep some 1,000 quantities now. Find the sub inventory. I will not choose FGS now. I will not choose FGS over here now. FGS now, I will not put 1,000 quantities. Okay, fine. So the sixth item, I'm going to keep 1,000 quantities in the second order now. Fine. Click on submit, which is now complete. I'm now keeping 1,000 quantities in the second order. Click on it. I will not change the org now. I will not go to the manage item quantities and change the org to first org. So second org only one is required. Fine, go there. I will not change the org to first org. Go there. It's a D011 entering now. Click on OK now. So the org changes. It will also vanish. And go there. Click on create miscellaneous transaction. Okay. I'm going to do all the transactions. So go to this place and then I make it as a miscellaneous transaction. Miscellaneous result. So here I'm going to do it. So the way in which I'm doing, you can do in your own way. Say that there is no such hard and fast rule that you have to do this first, next. Whichever way you feel convenient, you can do it now. You can modify your sequences actually. As long as you're understanding the concept, you can do it in any way. And click on plus now. So I'm now going to go and then populate my first stock D0102. Find your tab now. Second item. Go there. So we'll now go to this place and then go there. Go to the top now. High level reservation is complete. Find the second item. So here I'm now going to make a miscellaneous visit to 100 quantities now. Notice. Only 100 quantities required now. And then go there. And it will not ask any serial numbers at all because only at the time of pick it will ask the serial numbers. So if you give 100 quantities, it will not ask any serial numbers at all. Fine, go there, click on it. I will now go there, click on it. I will now put the FGS now. Fine, go there. I will now go to the edit detail now. Click on the edit detail. And then here, serial numbers will not be asked at all because only at the time of pick it will ask actually. Fine, go there, click on it. I will now put the 100 quantities. If they put the transaction quantity and then 100, give a tab now. Fine. The serial number has to come, it will not come. So this is the quantity which is received from manufacturing actually or from purchasing. So when you receive it, no serial numbers are asked. So click on OK. Any doubts on this now? So sub inventory is populated and then you know receiving it. So no serial numbers are asked during receipt into the inventory. Only during pick, it will now ask for the serial numbers. Click on OK. It is a new addition when compared to eBay. So click on plus one. So the second item is now done.
Nana, during manufacturing also it will not ask for a serial number, right?
Yeah. I told you, na. We are simulating it. Normally, it will now come either from manufacturing or from purchasing. Fine. So when you make a receipt into the inventory, when you are inventorizing the product, it will not ask any serial numbers at all. For the so third as well as the second and third. Fine. For both items, what happens? It will not be asking. So the third one, we'll go there. So we'll now have a look at now. Fine. Second one is there. Fine. The third one. So third one is what? It is the sales order issue. Now fine. Go there. So here I am going to make a miscellaneous to 100. Fine. So here, the 100, fine, go there, click on it, along, go on to the 100. And here, no serial numbers will be asked. So during pick also, it will not ask. Only during ship confirmation, it will ask for this one, third item. So click on plus now. It will go for the fourth item now. So it's a D0104, and then you tab now. I will now go for the fourth item. Then 2, 3, 4.
Go there. Then like this is like a just a concept wise or a business normally in the real life they can be used.
There are people who are using this as a business practice also. Fine. So we are not telling you all the flexibilities and then depending upon the requirement, you have to use those things. So here, whatever they go there. So we are going to manually allocate the serial number. Make system, select the serial numbers. So this one is the one. Fine, go there. So here, the fourth one is what? We are now going to define with the dynamic entry. And then here, I'm now going to create the numbers, 100 numbers. I'll be with the serial numbers I'm going to receive. So the result it will be coming, but we are now making the system select serial numbers is going to know now. Fine, that's what I want to know. So go to the edit details and then we have to give the serial numbers. 100 I'm going to get. So the moment I give a tab, you can now see on the right-hand side, the serial numbers will be enabled actually. It's a dynamic entry. So if you give it up, I don't know what I mean. So record lot and serial numbers, I'm going to get now for that count. I'm not going to manually enter it. Record lot and serial numbers, I'm putting it after the quantity is now put now. We go there. So go there, click on plus now, fine. I will now say enter serial number range actually. 100 numbers are required. So mon underscore 101 to mon underscore 200. So the mon underscore 101 and then give a tab. So it'll now the two serial number will be coming as 200. So all the 100 numbers are allocated or rather given a serial number, now 200. So click on OK and then we are now completing this transaction. So this is now completed now. This item is now completed.
So this is for dynamic entry?
Yeah, it's a dynamic entry. It's a dynamic entry. And so that's why we are able to manually enter the number. Had it been a predefined, we cannot enter like this. We have to first of all create the serial numbers and then only can enter.
Yeah,
this is dynamic. We can very well put any number now.
During transaction itself, we can.
Not during transaction. Yeah, during transaction, you're doing it. Remember, serial numbers are entered during transactions, and then lot numbers are created. What happens? Serial numbers are normally what happens when you want to generate serial numbers are generated before transactions, and then lot numbers are generated during transactions. So since it's a dynamic, it is allowing you to do it during transactions. Watch my inventory record; it will not teach you everything. Go there. That's it. Fine. Okay. Now, fine. So this item, fourth item, is ready. The fourth item is ready. Now go for the fifth item. Fifth item, you're going to go for. So there are two variants of shipping now. So it's not done. So I'm not going to keep 1,000 quantity and then the sales order is for 1,200. So we need a, what happens, your workflow customization. So we're going to this now. It's a no control item. We'll now keep 1,000 quantities on this now. Plus now. The fifth item, you're going to keep 1,000 quantities. So it's a D0105. Fine. Nomenclatures, you decide. Now, this is easy for me. If I give a tab, it'll automatically come. So 0203045. So you decide your own nomenclatures. It doesn't matter. But you can even follow my philosophy is good now, actually. I'm not going to give 1,000 quantities. And then the sales order is for 1,200 quantities now. Fine. So here, we are going to begin our workflow customization, actually, on this. And then click on plus now. Fine. So the sixth item is available in both the sub-inventories. Fine. It's a D0106. And then give a tab. So by tabbing it out, what happens, it'll be going. So it is already having 1,000 stock in the first, second sub-inventory. Now it's going to have 1,000 stock in the first sub-inventory also. If I made any mistake, please correct me then and there now. It is having a no control actually, 5,000. So sixth item is having stocks in both the warehouses actually. And that's it. The simulation is now complete. Fine. So we made a sixth item transaction of the second OR. Now from 2 to 6, we have now made a transaction of the first OR.
Sir, 1 minute. Like 106, you put only one sub-inventory. Na? So you mentioned 2 is sub-inventory. It is the
two inventory, not sub-inventory. The item is available in warehouse D011 as well as D012. And I'm going to change the warehouse and not the sub-inventory. During shipping, I'm going to make a change of the warehouse. Item is available in both the warehouses on the 1016, on the D012 also organization we have, and then D011 also we have. Any other routes? Good then, fine. Go there. Click on submit. Fine. Simulation is now complete. Fine. Click on it. Do it. So the transaction complete. Fine. Go there. We'll now go to the plan. Go there. Go to the supply chain planning. And then you go to the plan inputs and then it does not perform a collection. Sometimes collections do not work properly. Sometimes if it doesn't come, we have to collect everything on the whole. Now we'll now see. This instance is not too much corrupted actually. And we'll collect planning data. I will now collect only the items on hand now. Click on it. I'll go to the OPS and then I'll go for a targeted now. Targeted is a better one. Net change is a fast one, but since it's only few collections, I'm now going for a targeted. I will now choose items over here now. Click on it. So items and then organizations already collected, not necessary. Fine, go there, click on it. Go to the on end now. Sometimes when this is wrong, you have to collect so too many things now. So reference data is nothing but a static data, and then supply data is a dynamic data. So static and dynamic, we are not going on. So only these two things, fine, go there, click on it. They're not collecting it. Click on it.
Nana, sorry to interrupt. Just one question, Nana, because in the ATP rule, we have selected the infinite availability.
Yeah.
Infinite availability means it's not going to look at the on hand. Then why you need to collect on hand? That is,
if you don't have on hand, reservation will fail actually. Got it now? Fine. If the order management is not sensing the on hand, it will now fail at the reservation area. This is what is going to happen now. Fine. So here, this is somewhat cumbersome. I don't like the way in which it is implemented. Even I, when I was attending this training in Santa Clara, I asked the girls, and they came personally and told me, Nana, don't ask too many questions. We also have the same questions, but one of us, the JDM Red team is dominating this order management actually. Right? So they designed the philosophy actually. So they were unable to have any say at all. So it's all the concepts are, the order management concepts are similar to JD Edwards, that's what she's saying now. This is how we have to live with that. No other way. So if you want to, since you asked for it now, I'll show you what exactly happens in the EBIS now. The quality fusion now. I'll now go to the EBIS documentation and show you now. EBIS, oh God, not here. Quality fusion. One second, I'll now go to the fusion metric. The e-business documentation, I'll now go to the OEM now, and then I'll now go to the second day now, and we'll now see about how scheduling happens in e-business now. So scheduling is so easy, actually. I'll now see one thing on scheduling and reservation now. Oh, it is not there in this place. I'll now go to the OEM document one now. It's not also there. So it may be there in the third day now.
In day two, Nana.
Day two is there, huh?
Yeah.
Day two, first one, Nana.
Oh, it's there on the top. Not sorted properly, when scheduling and reservation. So here, how EBIS schedules now. In the EBIS, when a scheduling event occurs, it is now going to pick up the item, units of measures, quantity, and the requested date from the calling application. In this case, it's order management. The scheduling engine will fire, and then it's now going to give you the scheduled ship date and scheduled arrival date for the org mentioned on the, what happens on the org, which is mentioned on the sales order. So here, it is not so. You may mention org 3 on the sales order. But if the org 3 is not collected and refreshed, the scheduling is going to fail now. Sales order is saying org 3, but if org 3 is not collected and refreshed, it will fail actually. So it says that on the GOP area, the org must be available, then only we can go ahead on the scheduling. Bekar cheese. I don't like it at all. So Fusion also is going to give the same schedule ship date to sales order. But if the org is not collected, even though the sales order is having an org, it will not work at all. The philosophy is same, but it has got additional security or whatever nonsense you see. That is the way it works. So we have to live with it. So it's now getting collected. Now have a look at it. Go to those places. So you go to the tools, and then you go to the scheduled process, then have a look at it. The collection is going. So it is now, oh God, it is almost completed. So let us now run the what's called. So worker to delete stage data is the last one, so it does not run fast actually. I will not schedule it and then I will not do the refresh and start. So collections and refresh are a headache. Refresh and start on your tab. You're not collecting and refreshing it. So what else? This is again, I will not collect only for item and on and off. And we'll see whether it works or not. If it doesn't work, then I have to collect for more now. Let us see whether it works or not. Because these are the only things which are coming in now. Right? So collections will now bring it into the interface tables of the source systems now. Right? This will now make it visible for the order management now. So we are now going to refresh it now. On end and items can be consumed. Okay, in the meantime, we'll now go ahead on the fifth one now. Right? On the fifth one, we'll have one thing.
So how frequently you are running in your customer place this refresh and start Oracle?
One of my students is saying is horrible now. They are creating items day in and day out. And you know, whenever they run the collections, it takes around 2 hours before they create a sales order actually. And they already raised it.
On top of that, every time my transactions also fluctuate, right? On and everything will fluctuate. Yeah. Right?
But there is the supply fluctuations, there is a shortcut, I will not tell you. But for the static data fluctuations, you only have to collect and refresh. For the supply fluctuations, there is a shortcut. There is no need to collect and refresh. Will be coming to debited now. But for the static data, no other go. We have to only do the collect.
Yeah, static is okay, but only I'm thinking about the supply.
Supply is okay. Fine. Supply, they have made one change.
Static, I'm fine, I think.
1.5 years before, they made one change. That what happens is there is no need to collect and refresh for the dynamic data. Fine. For the dynamic data, supply data, there is no need. We'll be coming to it a bit later. I'll not show you.
Sure. Okay.
It's called start real-time update. If you do it, all the supplies, it may be a resource or whatever, maybe everything gets updated on the GPU area in one thing. So what you can do is you can schedule the concurrent, and then whenever a supply changes, this order management will be sensing it immediately.
That will be good, I think.
That is supply. And similarly, what happens, they have to introduce something on the static data also.
Yeah.
Unnecessarily, they brought into the GOP area. And order management should be independent of GOP, actually. I don't know why. The concept, they have got some concepts. No? All so many top people sat and then they decided the concept. See, it has to be user-friendly, first of all. That should be the ultimate aim. When you say you have to collect and refresh, and then only you can put on the sales order. Oh God, it was really very horrible. So it has all got complicated. So let us now begin, and then we'll now do the workflow customization once when number 5 comes in. Okay? 05 comes in. So it's all done. So whenever you make any major changes, you have a habit of signing out and sign in. Major changes, you sign out and sign in. Sometimes what happens, it doesn't work at all if you don't sign out and sign in. Major changes, you do it. Now we'll now begin with the second one. So since it is already collected, so for me, it's happening fast because they don't have much of a data on this now. Fine. Whereas when you're working on Israel PX or something like that, it will be having plenty of data, and then it will not take some long time. So the first one is completed. We'll now go for the second one. So serial generation and inventory pick. So while receiving it, it has never asked for it. So I will now book a sales order for 10 quantity. I will order in the shipment. So let us now book a sales order for 10 quantity. You go to the order management, and then you go to the order management, and then let us know. Create a sales order for 10 quantities. Now we are in the number 2 now. So if you give the number easily, what happens? You'll be able to remember it also easily. And then since I have given the data access only for the one BU, it's now coming. Whereas in your case, when you're working on a common one, if you're not constructed everything, and then you're working on the vision, you have to choose the business unit. Fine. You use one business unit, you have to choose it now. Whenever you're working on the blank one, and then there is no structure at all of yours now, you have to choose the first US one business unit, and then afterwards you put the customer. So for this, you can use the computer service, and the COMP is okay now for the vision. I'm not putting it on this. I will not put the second item. D0102. Fine. I didn't know how to remember what exactly is that. Fine. Second item is the one. Is that is the inventory pick now? So I will now go for 10 quantities now. 10 quantities. And then over there. So I'm not choosing 10 quantities over here now. And click on add now. I will now go and then populate my arrows over here. So Varro's population is not sufficient. It should have been collected and refreshed. Otherwise, what happens? You see, Anirban Saha is now facing a problem. So there will be so many issues which will be coming. So just like populating, it will not work at all. It should have been collected and refreshed, remember. Otherwise, it will not work at all. System will now fail on the scheduling. If the system fails on the scheduling, that means what? This Varro's is not available on the GOP area at all. It is not collected and refreshed. That is what the meaning is. If the scheduling fails, this Varro's is not properly collected. You have to collect the order orchestration reference object also, remember. Right? That is, whenever you make an infinite plan on the managed ATP, that should also be collected. First time you collect whatever the item organization on it, and then the next time when you make a ATP with an infinite ATP, that should also be collected. Only when you perform two collections and then refresh it, then only order management will now send you Varro's. On the first collection itself, you can populate your item on the Varro's in the sales order. But the second collection of your order orchestration reference object, if it is not done, sales order will fail on the scheduling. So click on submit now. Fine with that. So remember it, how it works. Whenever your scheduling fails, you should understand the second concurrent, second ATP setups, you will not have collected. The order orchestration reference object, you might have forgotten to collect it. So I'm now submitting this sales order now. Fine. It is an inventory pick. And 219 is now ready. Fine. Let's go on it. Will not go there. Go to actions. And then I go to the stupid one. So it will be getting progress. And then in the meantime, whatever, will not go there. Will not duplicate it. It will not go to the inventory now. So click on it. You go there. You go to what's called supply chain execution. And then you go to the inventory management. So in the inventory management, whatever, you go there. What is this place? 219 is my sales order now. So you go to the what's called shipments now. And then I go to the manage shipment lines. And then I can just put this as a before now. And instead of today, what happens? We put before. No need to put any dates at all. 219. We'll now see whether it has now got interface to awaiting shipping or not. So 219. Make a search now. It is not yet come. No, still progressing on this. Go to the fulfillment line.
Sir, can't we do this activity from OM level?
Which OM level? OM level, what do you want to do?
No, from order management level, means instead of coming to inventory and do this task, shipping activity.
A shipping activity, we cannot do in order management. We can do only in shipping. Sales orders will now progress it, and then it will now bring it to what? Awaiting shipping, and then now shipping activity has to be taken only in this place. Order management, we cannot do the shipping.
No, no, but because you came to inventory zone, and then you from there, you selected the task.
Yeah.
So in OM offering, it is not there.
OM, what can do? What can be done? You tell me where you wanted to do the shipping.
No, no, like in EBS.
EBS also, order entry will now interface with the shipping execution only. We cannot do anything on the order entry on the sales order as far as shipping
is. No,
No. What I'm saying, sir, in order management, super user responsibility will be having all the tasks, that all the functions.
Responsibility or menu?
Hey, there are menus, now fine.
That you can remove that menu.
We can even remove the menu. So here, the different screen. That menu is considered as a different screen. That's all I think.
No, here we don't have such option. Task will be not present in auto management offering.
You talk to the technical guys now, fine. So I understand that. What is your question? I understand now, fine. So what you're saying is that in this place, if you go there, why don't you add inventory management also over here now? Fine? That's what you're saying. Man. We can add it. In this place itself, we can add inventory management also. We can do it. We can very well do it. You need some technical knowledge. You must know roles and then other things now. Fine. Anything can be clubbed anywhere. The same functionality is available everywhere.
Basically, you have to create custom role and
custom role and then do all these things. Now,
In EBs also, the sitting menu is showing under order management because that is a sub-menu added to that main menu. Remove that sub-menu.
The same thing can be done here also. But no, I just want to a technical guy, you will be able to do it now.
Yeah, I just want to know either the scope is there or not.
Yeah, it's very much there. It is very much there.
We can customize the role.
To the custom role.
You have to get a custom role and then do it.
We can customize the role. No. We can pop up the infalets over.
Now we are in the second task. And then what happens? 100 quantities are now done. Fine, go the key. So during picking, it will now ask for it to what happens? Go there. So book a sales order for 10 quantities. We already booked in. So auto create shipment. So let us now do the auto create shipment. Fine, go click on it. Auto create shipment. The shipment number is now getting created. So the shipment number is now getting created now. So the shipment number will be coming now. Whatever. So I select it. Oh, I have not selected them. I select the line and then click on auto create shipment. So the shipment number will be coming. So 24008 is now selected. Now pick release the item. The data will not be staged at all. It will be released to warehouse. So we know when they automate it will never be staged. It will be released to warehouse because we have to say which 10 quantities there are mon_101 to something is there. So which one you are doing now? So I'll now click on the shipment and I will go on and launch.
This one, the reservation and scheduling, it's done.
Which one? Reservation is already done. Reservation is a high level, as well as it's called generic reservation. It doesn't reserve by serial numbers actually.
We can say it is a soft reservation.
It's a soft reservation or whatever. Yes. I'm not very sure.
So once we select the
then the hard reservation takes place.
Hard reservation.
Okay. Once when you select the particular piece, then there is a hard reservation. So it makes only a soft reservation. That's what you're saying now. Go there. Click on pick release now. Fine. It will never be staged. It will be released to warehouse. So concurrent is not running. Click on it. Okay. I will get it. So go there. Go to the tools and then go to the scheduled process and then you can see the concurrent is not running. So release pick wave is a concurrent which is now going to create a movement request now. And then it will not be staged actually because pick release and pick confirmation are the two activities. It will only do the pick release but not the pick confirmation. Somebody make an analysis. The document set now fine. My students are suffering like anything. The customer is asking to attach so-and-so documents. They were unable to attach it. Nana, this is not my cup of tea, and I don't know how to do this. And the pick release documents, the ship confirmation documents, and pick release documents, they were asking so many things. And I don't know how to attach them. I tried and then I couldn't exactly succeed.
That's the mandatory step now.
If anybody knows about the pick release documents,
ship confirmation documents, Nana sir, like in EBS, we have a reservation time fence which is responsible for this reservation.
No. Here is the time fence. Only the planning central. That is only in AACP, not for normal execution document. In the execution system of order management, we don't have any time fence at all.
No, reservation time fence is there in the OM system parameters in EBS, but I checked today in cloud, it is not there. I'm checking.
But will it work in EBS also? The reservation
It works there.
I never tested it actually.
But if I'm going inside 60 days something, then it will be high level reservation. It will happen like soft reservation. So normally some people, if they don't want to do the reservation, they'll put -1 something. It will never go any reservation. But that's not that correct functionality. People will not do that.
So that reservation time fence is not yet introduced in institution. That's what you're saying.
Which one is responsible for do the reservation? How the reservation automatically?
The workflow is now reserving it now. It makes a soft reservation at the sales order level itself. And then afterwards, you're now going to hot pick this now.
So it is not checking either the quantity is there or not.
It will not check the quantity. Let us say I have mon_101 to 200, out of which 10 quantities in generic are reserved now. Fine. So other sales orders can use only 90 quantities. If another sales order for 95 quantities, it will not fail at the reservation itself.
Why? Yeah, it will check the on hand and based on the org level, not in a sub inventory level or lot serial. Yeah. It will generically check the on hand in
org level and then it will make a soft
because we are not mentioning any sub inventory in sales order level. We are putting
sales level. Orders and lot serial numbers are not considered at the sales order level. So, but in the first one, we can even make a high level reservation that you have seen. Not fine. So, high level reservation for lots is very much possible.
So, the workflow is doing this or what?
Yeah, workflow is doing this.
So if we want the new order to be reserved, so
we can bypass the reservation. We are now going to on the fifth item. We are going to bypass it now. Fine, now see how to bypass.
You unreserve it and reserve it. If you
can, we can even bypass the reservation now.
No. The question is, we have a 1,000 organization 1,000 on hand, but one sales order is already reserved for 900. One more you are trying to reserve for 101. So then you will get an error. So on that case, exactly. if it is a priority, then you unreserve that existing sales order and you can
move. Yeah, exactly. Remove or reduce the reservation for the first one and then do it.
You can prioritize this.
Practical in the...
Yeah, it's all very practical.
Yeah, because it is error. Because it is error. Because, you know, the...
See, higher priority customer has come and so what happens? You will not reduce the reservation.
Yes. The organization does not have a on hand. How we can reserve it? How we can ship it?
So, this all...
Customer says, I'm going to pay tomorrow. They will even back order this consignment and then give it to him also. The entire thing will be back ordered and then given to this customer. We'll not see...
So, even there are some scenarios, Nana sir, even though I have a stock, I will not give to any customer. I'll back
exactly. You don't want to reserve anything at all. Right? Yeah. You I'll go and then remove the reservation buffer. There, isn't it? Okay, fine.
Yeah, it's a safety stock. Some average safety stock I'll keep as my buffer. I will expecting for different customers. That's the...
See, Subhul saying that what happens, you will not reduce the reservation because of certain considerations, then you will not keep some buffer of a safety stock and then do it. Right? There are so many practical things which you have to only work and then learn it. Here, we are only seeing the flexibilities on the system. Now, the system has now what go to confirm pick slips and then generate serial numbers.
No, 1 second. Like the managed shipment lines we created first, then we are doing the picking. But normally, what like order booking, then pick, then ship should be right.
Yeah, exactly.
Then why before the pick we generated the shipment?
Shipment number can be created. Shipment number is equivalent to delivery number of EBIS now. So we can create the shipment number.
Delivery number should be after pick, right?
No, not necessary. It can be even before pick. Delivery number can be before pick. When you have this number, what happens? We can even click on it and then you can go to this area and then do all the activities, whatever you want. Either action speak release or ship confirm or whatever it is you can do.
It's like EBS, you can do the transactions forms you are doing.
Delivery number can be created at any time. Even before picking, we can create. Right. After, while you're picking it, the system will be creating the delivery number automatically. We have auto create delivery.
Normally,
you have auto create delivery, it will be created. Here also the same thing.
But normally, in real time, no, sir. Pick release, everything will be scheduled. Auto pick selection list program, we will schedule based on schedule ship date, there are some priorities. Then automatically it will print in my warehouse printer, the picker will go and pick the print pick slip and he will go and pick it up. These are rare cases they will do this.
That's what I'm saying. Practically seeing what happens, you know, only understanding the functionality or flexibility which is available now. So you have to think a lot once when you go for an implementation. How to exactly fit the customer's requirement into the system, you have to think and then do it.
Yeah, this all will be automated, everything, the picture directly will go to the
printers. Need for you to create any shipment number and all. Fine. I am now doing it only for demonstration purposes. What Subhu is saying that everything will be automatic. No, nothing will be manual actually. Okay. Now, having done this, what happens, it doesn't release to warehouse. We'll have to go there and then do the thing. Fine. Go to the place and then I will now go to the pick confirmation. We have to do a perform pick confirmation. I can go to either inventory or shipments. In shipments also, we have a pick confirm. Fine, confirm pick. Or inventory also, we have a pick confirm. In inventory also, we have a pick and confirm picks. Fine. Anywhere you can go. And then we'll now query this. So we have to query it now. So one pick is open now. Fine. The one pick is open on the main dashboard itself, which is saying that it is not yet confirmed actually. Pick confirmation is not completed. Even if you click on it, it will not take you directly there. If you click on it, it will not go directly. So let me give a blank search now. Fine. See whether it comes or not. So on a blank search, because due date may be a problem now. We'll not see whether it comes or not. Otherwise, you have to put another criteria and then search it. Or from that place itself, we can come now. So it's not coming. So you go there, remove it, and then make a search now. Now it's coming. So from the dashboard itself, the info let itself will be giving you. So what happens is now that I'm going to click on select it now. Click on the pick slip, and then I'm going to perform a configuration. Right? Select both the lines now and click on it. And then here, I have to allocate the serial numbers. I will now have to allocate the serial numbers from serial number. So click on the peak to quantity. So then the moment you give it, now fine, it will not say which are the serial numbers you are selecting. That's all right. I will not write number. So here I am now going to generate the serial numbers. Remember, fine. Here serial numbers are generated. We are going to generate the serial numbers by doing it now. And then we are now going to associate. Fine, I will now say Zanana underscore 101 and then give it app now. I'm generating the serial numbers. This is called serial generation at peak. I'm not generating the serial numbers. Fine, go back to one. Done it. I click on confirm. So I'm now going to do a peak confirmation. So during peak confirmation, I'm now generating the serial numbers. Anybody, any questions? Because when I click on it, what happens? You cannot see the screen at all. Good then. Nobody is having any doubt now. Fine, go back to one. So I have to, if you have multiple lines, you have to click on this and then all the lines will be getting selected in one go. So we are generating the serial number. Fine, click on confirm. Confirm and close now. Fine, go back to one. So it is now generating the serial numbers and then it will now go to the staged area. And then afterwards, we have to ship confirm. So click on it. And then the sales order, the shipment line will be progressing it to what? You go there, click on it. It will now be progressing to stage. Select it. Click on search now. The shipment will be progressing to stage. And you see, even close now. It will be progressing to stage. That's it. This exercise is completed. Afterwards, you have to ship confirm and then the sales order will be getting updated. So it is now complete. So number two is now complete. You can read all these things. Now go for number three now.
No, I have one question. Now you are generating the serial numbers. Is there any way we can print labels from here or tags from here?
They're all available now. Fine. Every interface is available now. The label sticking and all this info interface is available. So if anybody has done it, please inform me now. I have to wait now. So external third party softwares can be very well integrated into Fusion actually. You can be able to do it. Label printing mechanism.
Okay.
Listen, you can even have a handheld device to do it now. Fine. Scan the item and then bring the item over here now. Fine. So whatever you're picking. Whatever you're picking, you show the handed gun to it now. The system automatically recognizes the number and then it will be populating on this. So 10 serial numbers, you show your handled gun, chick, 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 and then all the numbers will be coming into this.
So, Nana sir, like what is our, any separate module is there in ABS? We have MSCA, right? So yeah. Here we have.
We don't have a MSCA. Mobile supply chain application is not there, but any third party software can be easily integrated. There are so many plugins are available now, right? So they call this as an open interface and then it interfaces to many, many local legacy systems. It can be done. So with the help of technical, you will be configuring those things there.
Okay. Nana sir, then how it is different from this predefined one then?
What is the predefined one? Predefined means what? You have to generate and then keep it ready. Now, you are now generating it manually. It is a dynamic only. When you say serial number at inventory pick, it is a dynamic now. There is no, even if you generate it and then keep it, that also can be allocated. No problem at all.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You can generate it and then keep it ready, and then the generated numbers can be done, but manual number also can be done.
Oh, only the difference is it will be created over here directly, but that is the only difference.
You have an option of even generating and then keeping it ready, and then you can use those things also.
Yeah.
Very well. But you have a flexibility of what happens, your dynamic. When you say serial number generation, it's basically dynamic in nature. The control is basically dynamic in nature. So that is on 02. Now we'll now go for 03 now. 03 we are going for now. And the sales order issue. Fine. We'll now go on and get a sales order for this. We'll now give a cancel and then come back and then close it. So
no, question like we have many orders booked for an item, but we want reservation happen only for based on the request date. So no.
That sort of a facility is not available now. Fine, you have to customize it. I don't know whether that customization is available. Reservation based on, let's say, if a customer is asking for, let's say, it is not today's what? Today's 15th now. If a customer is asking on 17th, you won't reserve. If a customer is asking on next month, August, you should not reserve.
Right, so that sort
of a functionality is not available. Even in eBiz also, it's not available. You have to customize it. eBiz, we can very well customize it. But here, customization is somewhat difficult actually.
Okay.
So click on it. We'll now go for the 03 item. 02 is now completed. We'll now go for the 03. In doubts, 02 in doubts. We'll now go for the 03. We'll now go for the 03. Here, the generation is at the sales order issue and not at the peak now. We'll now go there. 03. 0, 0103. See, this numbering is easy. If you want to have a different way of numbering it, it's okay. So that's what is. We go there. And now, book a sales order for at the sales order issue. I will again book a sales order for 10 quantities. Now. So go there. 10 quantities, I'm going to put it. Click on add now. So we are now putting 10 quantities over here now. Click on add. And then I will now go and then populate my barrels over here now. Go to the supply and then let me populate the barrels over here now. And barrels is what? The D011. So click on submit, which what happens will be progressing now. So 220 is my sales order number. And then that is now progressing on the workflow. So it will now reserve it also for electronic. Now go there and have a look at it. Click on actions and then go to switch to fulfillment view. You want to have a look at it. So go there, go ahead on this one. And then go to the fulfillment view. It will now take some time for the inventory to sense this. These workflows are somewhat slow when compared to years. I don't know how they are all living with this. This do. This is called distributed order orchestration. Somewhat slow. I don't like it. Order my EBS, see how nice it is now. Very fast. It will not do everything. So
the moment. Sir, the moment you are booking the order, automatically this
scheduling. That's what I mean. It does scheduling and this thing. Within no time, it will be going to awaiting shipping now. Here, it will go to awaiting shipping. We have to go for a cup of coffee and then come back now.
No, sir. What I was asking, this scheduling automatically it is getting completed. So that it is checking something, some
program. No, it is checking the org. Na? The org should have been collected. I have now put D011 org in the sales order. Had it not been collected and refreshed in the GOP area, it will fail actually. Got it?
Okay.
So when okay. Only when you do the collection of what your manage orchestration reference object also then collect it, then only it will succeed actually. If you've done the first time collection, it will not do. Second time also you have to collect it now. Then only
so it means that this ATP rule is not playing any role here.
ATP is an infinite ATP, na?
Yeah, it is not playing any role in this scheduling.
You see, we have to create an ATP rule and then collect it. Infinite ATP and then collect it. So that is a procedure basically. If that is not done, the scheduling is going to fail. So the infinite ATP says what? We can now ship it whether we have on-hand or not. It now goes to the next step. But reservation will fail if you don't have a
on-hand. So it's a combination.
It's a combination basically.
Nana, I have a wonder.
So basically, it's a prerequisite if you want to get into the order. So you should have exactly. An ATP there.
Exactly.
Yeah, he's saying, who is this?
Karthik, sir.
Karthik is saying, what happens? It is a sort of a prerequisite now. So for the thing to be going into the order, what happens? You have to collect the order orchestration reference object also. Then collect.
Nana, one doubt. So once the scheduling, is started, it will give the once it is done, it will give the scheduled ship date. Yeah. So before reserve, it will give the scheduled ship date. Am I right?
No way. You can even in EBIS also only when you book it, it will now go for the scheduled ship date. We cannot give the scheduled ship date before booking. The customer has to confirm the purchase. Then only. Scheduled ship date can be manipulated.
That's correct.
You can give something and then you can even manipulate it. So here also upon booking only, the scheduled ship date can be manipulated. We cannot do it before booking. Scheduled ship date cannot be modified even in EBIS also before booking.
Now what he is asking before, it is not linked to reservation. He was asking that.
No. He wants to have a scheduled ship date on the sales order itself before booking.
No. I'm asking that the first when you book the order, the scheduling process will start.
Yeah.
So once it is done, the scheduling process is completed. It is then
not. It will not give the scheduled ship date.
Yeah, without reserving, how it gives the schedule? I mean, how system knows that this will be shipped on this date because there is no reservation like that. I'm asking.
See, I have now written a defaulting rule that what happens is scheduled ship date is going to be order date plus 4. Let us say. So. As soon as it schedules, it gives you the scheduled ship date as what? 15 plus 4, 19. But if there is no quantity, it will not fail on this next step. So we can decide by a defaulting rule, the scheduled ship date can be shipped before 4 days.
Normally, the scheduled ship date always will be a request date. You don't have any ATP.
Exactly. What's the saying?
Here, nothing but
customer maybe. No, today's date is 15. Yeah. The customer wants it on 19th. The scheduled ship date will be 19th.
Even the system will never care about whether you have on hand, you don't have anything. Yes. It will give the bogus date. It will never worry about that because we don't have any ATP. If your ATP is enabled properly based on the supplier lead time, it will check all your incoming supply, in-transit supply and the demand. Yeah. It will plan and it will calculate internally some algorithm. It will put the scheduled ship date, maybe 1 month, 2 months. Again, what people will do means, again, they will override the scheduled ship date, they put it next day because he is my priority customer.
Fantastic.
That's the real time.
Yes, so they will override it. Yes, exactly. Fine. Announce yourself as a friend of Subbu. He has got a lot of practical knowledge on this now. Fine. He'll be very helpful for you during implementation.
Yeah,
I don't have anything. Fine. So he'll be a very great help for you. Fine.
He already is my friend.
He's already your friend. Okay. So now it has been interfaced to what happens.
I have a question.
So if we don't want to do the reservation, so do
we are going to see the fifth item. I don't want to give a reservation now. On the fifth item, you're going to see, but how to bypass the reservation you're going to do. We are going to customize the do now. You will be customizing the do on the fifth item and then we are going to do it now.
Because
normally that's not the correct process, right?
Yeah, it all depends upon the end client's requirements. If you want to bypass or not, you decide.
It depends on the business, the kind
based upon the business model. I'm going to teach you what is available now, fine. You're not playing a chess. I'm not telling you how the rook moves, how the pawn moves, how the queen moves. But
anyhow, you have to move, you know, inventory allowed.
No. Hold on. If you are not reserving your quantity, always what will happen, right? My supply and demand will not properly show. And then on top of that, I'm an inventory manager. I'm going and seeing the my on-hand stock. Okay. It will show available stock 100, available to transact 100, available to reserve 100. But that's not so, a real, right?
Yeah.
So already my demand is exist this side.
So exactly. What happens in the plant, in real world, they may not use the Oracle for their full capability.
That is true. See, these are all case by case. This is whether you want to bypass reservation or not, you have to take a decision on the field.
They are happening outside of Oracle and then they are interfacing it. So when
in that case, yes, I agree that. Yeah, in that case, I agree. It's a virtual transaction in Oracle. I know, because one of the projects I implemented is a warehouse completely picking, shipping, everything handled outside. Oracle just like a virtual transactions.
And Oracle is, their order screen, it's so cumbersome. Means you don't go and create orders in the order Oracle screen, or do the shipping. So there are other systems like scanning based systems, automatic systems, RFID.
You now push everything into Oracle, huh?
And then you push it to Oracle. So that's why I'm asking the feature how to override the reserve.
See, I'm going to teach you about how to override the reservation, but whether you want to, as Subbu is saying, if required, use it. Otherwise, don't use it. I'm going to teach you about how to bypass the reservation. I will teach you.
Yeah.
But practical case is a different one now. Fine. You only have to decide whether to bypass or not. Fine.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it is not on the fine. It is not want awaiting shipping. Let us now go there and then 220. We are going to pick it up. This time, while picking, it will never ask anything at all. Click on search now. While picking, it will never ask at all.
This time it will ask during ship confirmation.
During ship confirmation only it'll ask. It will never be going to release to warehouse. It will be going to what? It will be staged also automatically. It will be staged also. It will be going to stage now. So here you see, I am not creating any shipment number and then I am now going to do it now. Fine, go to actions and I'm going to pick release. So without creating a shipment number, I'm doing a release also. Fine, click on pick release. Somebody asked why we have to do it before now. Fine, there is no such hard and fast.
Nana sir, one minute. Nana sir, can we go to the create pick wave and confirm pick wave like that?
Oh God, I have already given it. No, I should ask me before.
Next time we'll do that.
Okay.
Somebody was asking, right?
We can also do that. No, fine. I have already shown you about how to go to the create pick wave on the with the pick wave release rule, and then you can do
that
it.
That is manual way.
Yeah.
We can very well do it now. So go there and then here ready to release and then make a search again. Now, you can search now. We can do this. And it'll be staged actually.
So this was there also in EBS.
Yeah. Sort of these functionalities are all available in the user, and there is no change at all. Oh God, it has not been released to warehouse now. So, okay, I don't know why it has gone released to warehouse. Okay, we'll now see, but why it has not gone to find out that you want it. I will now give what I've been done and then come back now. Fine, there's no release to warehouse. But we need to allocate the numbers only during pick confirmation actually. The open picks are two now. Fine, click on it. I will now see on the click on this. So it's open now. Fine, click on this and then go there directly.
So here also the serial number, state and status, everything it is same as EBS?
Yeah, everything is same. The shipping functionality, they are not changed at all. So I'm now clicking on this main one now, man. On the dashboard itself, I'm seeing, man, now showing two picks. The one is already come. So we can even go via this. Go to the pick component. So you go there, select it, and then 10 numbers are there. Pick the quantity. So you should not ask anything at all. Fine, go there, click on 10. So go there, click on it. And then my question is, why it has not done the pick confirmation automatically? Because I don't need to have to allocate the serial numbers. Now, fine. Subbu, tell me why it has not done directly. It should have gone to stage, no? That is what I expected. But it has now gone to release to warehouse, actually. Why? I don't know. Oh, God, something. I might have made something on the organization parameter. Or
yeah, correct. Pick the organization parameter is the pick that you have confirmed.
Go there and see. No, fine. Organization.
There is a checkbox in the organization parameter.
I might have made it.
Sir, it means that
yesterday you made that, Nana sir.
Okay. I will now go on.
Sir, it means that allocation is done and confirmation is not done.
Exactly.
Yeah,
no, during confirmation only we are going to allocate it. During confirmation only allocate. So I'll now go there and then have a look at my final point. I'll now go to the manage inventory or click on search. Go there. So manage
warehouse allocation.
I don't know. So we go to the manage inventory or click on it. I'll now have a look at it now. So organizations are D011 now. Entry now. Oh, what happened? So not much.
I think release to warehouse allocation it is completed.
Not allocation is completed. Usually what happens is the movement request only allocation is not completed. We are not going to allocate. So here there is no allocation required during pick confirmation. Fine, go ahead, click on next now. Only movement request is created, it is not allocated. Fine, go ahead, click on it now. Fine. Ah, this is the culprit. Come on here. Remove it now. At least I identified there. That is why it is not going to stage. Otherwise, it would be going to stage. Because no need to allocate the serial numbers during picking. Only during shipping we had to allocate. So because of this tick mark, what happens? It does not release to warehouse. Fine, good. I know it's removed. So manual pick confirmation is required. You go to this confirm picks and then go there. So during picking, no need to give the serial numbers at all. Only during issue we had to give it now. Remember, fine, go there.
So Nana sir, if you back order this and then can we just do it so that it's going to be staged?
Okay, you want to do that now? Fine, go ahead, click on it.
I will not. But it's a functionality, right? Even that can be set.
Yeah, we can do it now. So first of all, let me pick and then we can do the back ordering. Fine, let us now do the pick order and then do the back ordering. Fine, select it now. Then now do the picking and then do the back ordering. Fine, click on it. So let me pick first now.
There is a bug in the back order. If my material is staying in my staging area, if you do the back order in Toto 8 or 12, but I don't know about cloud.
Okay, we'll now see.
So
we'll
do the back ordering. Order will be back order, but still my material will show in my staging area. You have to do the subordinate transfer again.
Oh, ho, 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 ho. He says the material reserve remains in the staging area. Back ordering is only what? So confirm and close. Fine, click on confirm and close. We'll now see
that. Remember that, Subbu sir.
Done. Okay. We'll now go there. We'll now perform a back ordering on this. Now go to this place. And then
Subbu, there's a new feature where it will put it back original area in the new release. I think it's
12.2.8.
Told 8 only. No, told 8 only I tried. Even last week, my users are telling why my material is staying in the staging area.
Now, we'll do the back ordering. We'll now see the item is available still on the staging or not.
Sure.
So click on the shipper now. Let us now do the back ordering. So before I ship confirm, what happens? I go there. I will now say in the bottom, I'm going to mention how much I'm shipping it now. My shipped quantity is zero. And then zero, and then give it tab now. The back order quantity is what 10 now. I'm not doing it. So while ship confirmation, I'm now performing a back ordering. So go there, click on ship confirmation, it will now get back ordered. So ship is back ordered, it's now fine. I'll now perform a ship confirmation. This is the way we had to back order. So we are now back ordering it now. Click on it.
There is a one option in actions back order.
There is also available. So there are plenty of
even,
ways.
Even line level also, we can do
actions. Can, there are so many ways we can do it.
Why are you back ordering this?
He is saying, Rambu Bachu asked me to back order because of which I'm doing it now. What he's saying is that, so once when it is back ordered, if you do again a pick release, whether it goes to the staged or not automatically, that is what he wants to see now. So click on it now. So it go down. So even close now. We already done the back ordering. It's not getting back ordered here. It should have been back ordered. No? Okay. It has now removed the shipment. Remember, the shipment is unassigned, but it remains in the staging. That's what Subbu says. Now fine. It is now remaining.
Yes.
You can check in fulfillment. Whether it is status, any status change. In order of fulfillment, any status change?
No change. That will not be. So there, here it will not do anything at all. Here.
No, line status should change. It's a back order, Nana sir. But only
That would be we need to define in a.
See, in the sales order, there's no change at all on the line status. Even picked is coming in EBUS. Here it is not coming at all. The picked status, we are not able to see. Picked and picked partial will be coming in EBUS. Mm-hmm. Here I am not seeing it now. Fine. From awaiting shipping, it goes only to a shipped status now. It doesn't do anything at all. The picked also is not coming over here now. Now we'll now see, check what happens. What happened now? Fine. In this place, what is this now? In the shipments, it is no. It has to show me as a back order now, but it is unassigned the shipment, but it is not showing me as a back order now.
You just cancel this one, go to pick release screen from inventory.
Okay. You can cancel it now. I will now again go there. Requery you are saying, no, fine, go there, click on it. I will now requery it now. So click on it, I will now make it the before, and then 220 is the one, and then give it a tab, and then click on search now. We are learning from the experts actually. Go there. So now, it is now staged, it is now in the staged area only, but it needs a pick releasing actually. We will now see on the stock now, fine, go there, click on it. Now have a look at the stock, that's what Subbu says. If the stock remains in only stage, that's what he's saying now. Click on it now. go there. The stock remains in one state. So you go there, and then here on this place, you'll know, go to what? Go to the, what's called, we had to go to
supply chain. Nana, one thing you'll notice in that page you have opened, na, that back order quantity is showing zero. When the shipment has been unallocated, still the back order
one second, quantity is showing zero. Let us not see the stock on this. So it's a D0103, isn't it? Fine, 03 is the one. I click on search now. They're searching for it now. I don't want to expand it. So it's all organization will be showing everywhere, but they're really available in one place now. I'm going to expand it now.
So what is the expected behavior? What your
expectation? This is what is happening actually. The expected is different. So what happens? It remains in the stage only. That's what Subbu says now. Even if you back order it, the item remains one in the stage and not go to the. So one guy, Salman is saying 12.2.8, it comes back to FGS. That's what Salman, you are saying, right?
There's an option that they had introduced that you can move it back to the to the finished good or wherever it was picked.
Okay, wherever it is picked.
The other thing is, means in this, the line status itself is. It's
still
not
we can
changed.
See the line status.
Why? Line status is not changed. Yeah, fine. That's what I was worrying now. Line status has not changed.
No, no, sir. This back order, you will see the status change in
where exactly
back order and also the quantity will not move back.
That is very I can see the back order status now. Fine. Yeah. It is only unassigned the shipment now. But it should not, it has to show as back order.
Yeah, no, sir. You say back order quantity 0, you put the 10 there instead of ship quantity.
Okay, this is 0.
The negative 0, you put it a back order 110. Then okay. You can just complete it.
Save it.
Yeah.
It will save now. Whether it will not change.
It should happen now, I think. It should change now, line status.
Line status is not. Save and close now.
Save and close.
Go there. Click on.
I go and check in the shipment.
Yeah.
The shipment lines. So we are learning from experts actually.
No, here Ram Kumar is the expert.
Ram Kumar is the expert. Okay. Hey, Ram Kumar, come on. Jump in. Ram Kumar, jump in. He's an expert. Come on, yaar.
No. I'm also learning.
Oh, God. Somebody tell me about how to do this now. I want this to be back ordered now. So now when I launch the pick release, it will be doing the pick release and pick confirmation also automatically. So let us now go there and launch it now. So go to the actions and go to launch pick release. Fine with that. So it will not give a pick release. Fine with that. It will not do the pick release as well as the action cannot be performed in the selected record. So it is already staged. This is what I'm saying now. Come on, yaar. I am unable to perform it at all.
Let's see
already,
action,
item is already staged action, actually. Actions and then
let's see. Is there any other options?
Any other option to back order? Come on. We will now give it to the team. Now, fine. Let somebody tell me about how to back order it. Yaar.
Sir, you need to unassign from shipment.
It is already unassigned.
Yeah, actually. Already done.
It is already done now. The system has done the unassignment from the shipping now. Fine. So somebody work on it and then tell me how to bring it to back order. There's a lab exercise. Fine. Somebody, fine, including Ram Kumar. Fine. So now,
log out and try once, man.
Oh God, log out.
Auto create and see that again.
I don't think log out is required for this action. So you try. Somebody try and tell me when you have done it like that on a back ordering it is not happening at all. Oh God. Now we go and then perform the ship confirmation. I'll auto create the shipment now. Fine. Only without a shipment, I cannot ship confirm it now. Ship confirmation, we need a shipment number. Fine. Go back to on it. So at this time, we had to allocate the serial number. So if you want to ship confirm, you have to go in the bottom and then allocate the serial. The serial numbers are going to allocate. Now. So here, shipped quantity, I'm going to put as 10 now and go there. Back order to 0. Then we have to allocate the serial numbers here. Serial numbers as we go. So serial number need to be allocated only during ship confirmation process. Fine. Go there. I will now say, Nana2_101. I think it is invariably only dynamic. It is not static, predefined at all. It is invariably dynamic.
Yeah, you will generate it here.
Yeah, we can generate the serial numbers only. Yeah. The serial numbers are generated and not predefined, I think. That's it.
Yep.
So this number is now generated during the ship confirmation. Fine, go there. Click on it, ship confirm. So I now put it in corners. Fine, go there. So click on ship confirmation and that what happens will be like. Oh God, we got delayed like that. So the weight and volume, we can ignore it now. Right? Weight and volume is recorded only for the transportation management. So the warning, okay, cheapo, you can say click on this now. Now it will be shipped. And then you can even very well see on the what's called manage item quantities. Fine, whether click on change the organization and then put the item over here. Right? So click on the D01 now. Click on again now. And then you'll now query for the third item. Right? Click on it. We are taking more time, but doesn't matter. We are now understanding a lot. Now, fine. All of you agree now? Click on search now, fine. You'll see. You'll now have the serial numbers also allocated. So here we have in the FGS, we have this many. It has to come in the staged area, isn't it? Fine. It is now ship confirmed. It has gone out now. It has now gone out now. So since it has gone out, it is not showing you. The FGS staging is not having any quantity, it's now gone out. So we can even see on the serial numbers now. Click on it.
You can check in the material transaction.
Yeah. Material transaction also will show. Yeah. Managed serial numbers also. Yeah.
Review completed transaction.
Yeah, in the review completed transaction also, not so fine. Click on it. The D0103. And now. And then click on search now. Click on search. You want to search it. Click on search it. It will not show you the serial numbers which have been 902. Fine, 902. This many have gone. So it is manually generated numbers which are not showing over here. So this is called SO issue. Fine. Serial numbers are SO issue. Oh God, I have completed only 2.2 items here. Zero.
One question, maybe basic question. So we have created two sub-inventories. One is FG, one is stage. So yeah. How up from FG to stage is moving out? Because
whenever you are launching the pick release, in the shipping parameters, we have already defined which is our staging sub-inventory. So from the FGS to stage, it will now move automatically. In the shipping parameters, we have said which is our staging sub-inventory. So from the FGS, it will now pick now. So item may be available in multiple sub-inventories. Depending upon the picking rule, it will now pick. The last in first order and first in first order, you will have the picking rules. The picking rules will now help you in picking from whichever sub-inventory is appropriate. Then the power of picking, and then finally put it on the stage area.
The movement request will generate.
Yeah, the movement request will generate. The movement based request on the release will be using the powerful feature the of picking rule.
Yeah.
Based upon not release rule, based upon the picking rule.
Yeah, sorry. Based on the picking rule.
Yeah. That's it for the day now, fine. We are now complete only two items. I planned for 06 onwards. I couldn't progress because of very good interactions actually. You like it? Anybody is now objecting to it or what?
No, finally back order is not worked.
A back order didn't work here. Ramu Bachchu, you only have to tell me about how to back order.
Maybe we can try back order at the time of ship confirm, entering the quantity in back ordered.
Maybe if you do it, that. Who is this?
Anush,
what are you saying? During pick confirmation, you cannot do the back ordering, but during ship confirmation, if you put as an N and then do a different confirmation, what happens at the time? It will not back order. But we did the same thing here.
I experienced same, but my instance it worked well. I don't know, but it took some time to dig. But I don't know.
You have to dig deep into it and then see this. No, man. Even the main one is not updating it. Actually, man. It is confirmed.
During pick confirmation also we can backorder.
Okay. During pick confirmation also, if you give a zero quantity, it gets backordered. Huh? Who is this?
Hello. Tushar
is saying. During pick confirmation, if you put zero quantities and then give a confirmation, it gets back ordered. Beautiful. There's a good one. Fine. You can even do this now. During pick confirmation, if you give a zero quantities and then give a confirm, it gets back ordered. Good.
No, I have one doubt.
Yeah.
Hello?
Tell me.
Yeah, regarding, suppose you say it is not interface to AR means, where to check the sales order is not interface to AR means.
Sales order after going to shipped status will be interface to AR.
If it's
so
not you interface have to
run the order invoice now.
No, okay. No.
You're saying your crate billing is not coming.
No, not billing.
Awaiting billing is not coming.
Not coming. It is stuck
if awaiting billing is not coming, AR is not settled. We have to set up the transaction source.
No, that is where to check that interface table.
Where it will not go into the interface table at all. It is now lying in order management. See, awaiting billing has landed in the error means what? It has never gone to the interface tables of AR. Only awaiting billing makes the item available, makes the line available on the interface tables of AR.
Yes.
Only when it is awaiting billing, it will now reach the interface tables of AR. If it is awaiting billing itself is a billing line is an error, it will now remain only in order entry. We have to set up AR. AR has to be fully set. Then only we can push it into AR's interface tables.
So this invoice import program, it runs.
The auto invoice program will now bring it from the interface table to the base table.
Yeah.
So once when you make an invoice, the line gets closed. Got it now? Once when you make a line.
So if you have multiple organization, I cannot check multiple sales orders is there. Okay. I cannot check it. Suppose 100 sales orders got stuck in interface means.
Oh God.
How can I check?
MK is saying, what is your full name here, MK?
Magesh is saying
that what happens if you have 100 sales orders and then many are stuck in the interface tables. What is the best method? I think probably there is a interface lines we can very well check in AR actually. How many are stuck? If you go to AR, you'll have the facility to check all the interface lines which are struck and then which is because of want of something.
In AR, we have an open interface from that spreadsheet will open that. Good. There you can check all the airlines which are in error and what is the status.
Exactly.
In sales order line, it will be closed. There's no issue with the sales
order. Once when it is created, once when the invoice is created, the line gets closed.
Yeah.
The invoice is not yet created, it will be still awaiting billing money.
Yeah, there's a one feeder system program will run that will change the status of sales order line.
Good. Any other questions now?
Sir, there is a report, right? Cox revenue matching report. There is a normally the month and what they will do means they will run the COX revenue matching report. They will run the report and they will see how many orders they are not at COX revenue.
Amma?
So here, that report will help you that complete your shift status for trucking in the ITS also. It will give the complete details, which order, what details, why, which line, everything. So mostly normally those who are closing the periods before that inventory closing, finance period closing, they will run these reports.
So, what is the report name?
Yes, sir?
What is the report name? What you told now?
COX revenue matching report. That report will give the complete details. COX
revenue matching report, okay.
Yeah. That's one of the report normally finance people will check how much cost is revenues recognized between the my order and the invoice. And that will give you, is there any difference also? And then from there, they will take it back from the reverse engineering. They will start on either any accounts, maybe the SLA, estimation, everything. That's one of the checklist in the month end closing activities.
Nana, sir, the return order is not working.
PX, now fine. Leave it. Man. There is some problem there.
Yeah, you need to show it.
You don't do it and then go ahead and then only with the one shipped line, you complete step number 68. No? There is some problem. Subbu has already told that the return workflow is not firing there. Somebody has done something there.
Nana sir, as EBS here also we have this interface status and that one also infusion also here.
It is interfaced. You can see on the shipping area what happens, it will be interfaced actually. The moment it gets done. The line will be interfaced to order entry actually. The same status is coming here also.
Good morning, Nana. Rajesh here. I have a question for Ramu, our pricing expert. There is one instance where I don't see business unit in the pricing strategy assignment. So, how to enable? I know that it is through managed service mapping.
Yes. In a matrix class, managed service mapping, you need to add that the business unit and you need to add the condition that header dot business unit. Then that will be comes to the pricing status. There is the edit button. You can check it and that will be populated in staging assessment.
Ramu, can you take one session on this pricing algorithms now?
Ramu, if you can at least show this quickly, we will get...
No, while I'm doing it, you guide me. I will not, based upon the guidance, I will not do... Okay, fine. When you're doing the pricing now. When you're doing the pricing, you please help us. We will not jointly work also. You may not be knowing the full ones now.
Yeah.
Jointly work and then we will not try to identify something.
Yeah, definitely. But, Rajesh, I'll tell you.
If we add this, right, it will help a lot because there are different...
Anu.
I just ping you that note. So it's actually in 2.9, not
2.8. Oh, 2.9, he's saying that it has a good option of bringing it from staging to FGS. Good, Salman.
Yeah, even now, we raised the SR to Oracle also, Salman, but no luck.
Yeah, but if you are planning to upgrade, so this feature would work. And they,
now we are going live. they don't have any budget.
Okay.
They started ramming down the team also.
So I was wondering that they should have it in the cloud also, in this Fusion instance also.
It should be,
12.2.9, then it should be in this Fusion.
Good, then we had a good session. We learned a lot now, fine, through interactions. We found that during pick confirmation, if you give a zero quantities, it gets back ordered. That is what somebody told me. Who is that? Somebody told. Okay, fine. That's good. Good information. Fine. You can try those things now. Yeah.
Sir, do we have here also like metal transaction form?
Yeah, metal transaction form. What do you want to do actually?
No, means if I want to see all my transactions.
Yeah, we can review material transactions. Right? We have one review completed transactions.
Review completed
equivalent to material transactions of EBS. Review completed transactions is equivalent to material transactions of EBS.
Ram, can you send screenshot about the navigation so that we can use it?
Sure, Rajesh, I will do it.
Thank you.
Ramu is going to help us in pricing algorithm. And then whatever half knowledge he has, we will try to explore now when we are doing the pricing.
Please share the document in WhatsApp.
No, you can put it to, send it to me, I will now upload. Fine. Any documents, whatever you have, send it to me.
I have a lot documents, but the thing, my system got crashed. So that's the reason I logged on. I'm working with my admin team to restart my hard disk. So if it is get restored, I will definitely share the documents to you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Suppose we are putting requested date tomorrow, first date. And our transit time setups are like 5 days. The schedule should get considering the concept time.
No, that concept is yet to come now. Fine. Based upon your requested date, based upon tomorrow is to 17th and then 25th, what happens? You want to have something else? That sort of a thing is not.
Because the transit time inclusion logic is.
We have only one concept that what happens. The scheduled ship date can be, as Subbu was saying, it will be normally the requested date. The scheduled ship date will be set to requested date. And then in defaulting, we can even make an adjustment. But apart from that, there is no other functionality.
Yeah, the scheduled arrival date will be based on...
can be scheduled ship date plus 2. That also can be said, no. Because the interlocation transit times are yet to work here, no. Fine. Only with the transportation management, it will work. So if you have implemented the transportation, then probably, let us say, from Madras to Bombay, it's going to take some 5 days, no. It automatically populates the scheduled arrival date based upon your transit times, actually. But even though we have a transit time here, but that doesn't put the scheduled arrival date automatically over. We need to have Oracle transportation. Good then. Any other questions? Otherwise, we'll not call it day now.
So, Nana, sir.
Yeah.
One information like through managed shipments also, we can do in a back order, specific line or all lines are available.
Managed shipments. We have gone only there now, fine. We go to the managed shipments only. We tried
to
the stage only. We tried
it. If you go to the shipment, we are open, then they put the back order quantity, right? Then there's an option when you open the shipment number, right? It will open another screen, edit shipment screen, where you can select your line. And in your actions, you can do like a one line back order or all the lines.
No, see, tomorrow, fine. You know, have a look at it tomorrow. You can try that. He's saying something. Ram Kumar is an expert now.
Please don't say that.
He's in a big company and then he's an expert. So he's saying that there is in the shipment number, there is one more form where we can edit the shipments. That's what he's saying. While editing the shipment, we can even choose it as a back order and go it and it gets back.
Nana, let me share my screen.
Okay. Speaking here, you can open up your video also.
Not an issue. Rajesh, you can see. Rajesh, you can see the managed pricing as matrix class sales price strategy assignments. You can add your business unit here.
As one of the classes.
So there's a header, billing, third party account. You can see that multiple and third party account.
There are plenty of options here, na?
And you can add and you need to define one lookup first. Either you can take you can use a lookup or a SQL code or whatever. It's like a lookup or a custom and SQL code, whatever you just define and get those business IDs, business unit IDs, and you can match here and post that.
BU specific way to do all these things. The purchasing prices itself is BU specific. Na? If you make multiple purchase prices with different BUs, that's solved. No problem is solved. Why do you go for this now? This route is not required at all. BU specific pricing is very easy because price list is BU specific. So create multiple BUs and then that only will fire. The other ones will not fire at all. Why to add it here now? We'll now have a look at it. We'll now debate on this during price list actually, pricing sections now.
In a managed pricing strategy assignment, you can edit your rules and columns and
You first of all, justify me when I'm doing pricing, why this is required. And this much of a composite, why is it required? Right? The price list itself is BU specific. So we have multiple prices for different BUs. That only will fire. The other ones will not fire at all.
I have two business units, Nana, for the same customer.
Okay.
So while item are being same. So while I selected a business unit over...
The sales order.
And the same order.
BU1, so price list only will come. The price list is point of BU1. And if the sales order saying BU2, the BU2 specific prices only will come. So there is no need for this much of activity or the pricing strategy assignments and all. It is automatic.
Okay. That is all. So while creating the price list, we'll get a BU.
Ah, prices itself will be having a BU. No? So why to go?
Yeah, price list is BU specific.
Yeah, that's right.
Price list is BU specific. The same, right?
Yeah.
Even EBS also will do the OU specific one.
Right? Yeah. Everything is OU specific. Yes. In EBS also, it's OU specific.
So, okay. Then, and then that case, not a price. BU is not required. But anything, any want, any change you want, you can use this. These are the compare attributes. So, based on this compare attribute, you can add anything. And if you want to add a new compare attribute also, you can do it from the sales mapping. So, header dot those line level, and you can take the line level or header level, you can take, and
we'll discuss on this later. There are plenty of options available there now. We'll now discuss it later. That's it. Fine, go there. So I'm now leaving now. So can you stop sharing? No, stop the recording now.
Stop. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Bye.